This is Chairman Downey, Chairman of the Republican Party of Minnesota.
So it sounds to me like you're ready to elect some Republicans in November, am I right? Well, let me take us back just a little bit. On July 4th, 1854, a group of Minnesotans calling themselves Friends of Freedom gathered for the first time in a small schoolroom in St. Anthony. They were Whigs and Democrats, opposed to slavery and corruption in the territorial governments, and who believed that only a new political party could accomplish their aims. They founded the Republican Party of Minnesota. Today, 160 years later, the Republicans of the 4th Congressional District are met again in a school. Friends of freedom like our forebears and equally committed to their original causes. And yet Republicans are said to be at a crossroads. Well, I've traveled across this great state, and I'm more convinced than ever that the real crossroads are the choices facing our state and our country, and that the path forward for Republicans is to be found in one simple, powerful fact. We are on the side of the people. Believe it. And now with our state party back on its feet, I believe we're ready to make a difference. We've restructured our operations, our communications, our finances. We've reduced our annual operating costs by over $200,000 a year. We've reduced our debt to the point where it will only be 10 to 15% of our budget this year, so the vast majority of the money you contribute and others around this state will go to winning elections in 2014. We replatformed our technology. We've quadrupled the amount of voter information that we have for our candidates and for you, and we have built the plan for an unprecedented Minnesota Victory program this year, an unparalleled ground game. But that doesn't win the election, does it? More than that, Republicans have to be ready to earn the people's trust, ready to work for all Minnesotans and their opportunity to pursue big dreams again. While Republicans are always going to encourage an internal iron sharpening iron debate, we reminded ourselves after that last election that, you know what, our party is not an end unto itself. We exist to lead the causes that will make our state better, to provide statewide leadership for the things that will advance the lives of our people. Republicans and our candidates will take our cause of growth and opportunity across this entire state. We will listen and we will lead. So for all of this, and you know what, it is so much, isn't it? I'm asking you here to stay positive, to remain bullish about our future, and to hang together for the long haul. In 2014, Democrats fear one thing: a united Republican Party getting back in front of the people and speaking the truth. And know this, Minnesotans aren't just interested in what we believe, they're watching how we behave. And while we'll never pretend to paper over our differences, this debate is far too important. I'm asking each one of you to bring a little dose of humility and some charity and grace in our dealings with each other. And while we are always going to be held to a double standard by our opponents, let our own internal standard be higher, not out of fear, but in bold leadership. Lincoln said that a good leader is one in whom we have confidence. A great leader is one who instills confidence in ourselves. That sums up our country's challenge, doesn't it? Our people need to regain confidence in themselves again. Sometimes from the state party chair, it feels to me like we got a 30-year greatest generation challenge in front of us. Seems like an uphill climb, but you know what? It starts right here with us today. Each one of us in this room needs to be that kind of leader for your community. You're the one that has the voice. You're the one that has the ear of your friends and neighbors. And with leadership like that from you and from our party, you know what? I believe Republicans can have a resounding victory in November, and not for ourselves, but for the people of our state. What an opportunity we have. I am so honored to be doing it with all of you. We need your help, we need your passion, your time, your money, your commitment. I thank Jim and the team here at the 4th Congressional District. We will not win this election without a strong 4th Congressional District, and frankly, without a strong city committee operating in St. Paul. You got a big day ahead of you here, and I wish you well with all of your important decisions. After the endorsements, we come together to fight tooth and nail for our endorsed candidates. And if we have to, if we're forced, we're gonna come together after a primary. and we go for the win together in November. The people of Minnesota are depending on you. Not the way Democrats want people to depend on them. They are depending on you to fight for their liberty, for their justice, for their opportunity in life. Thank you and have a great convention.